Welcome back, Chris here. Let's take a look at one of my favorite applications, Microsoft OneDrive. So if you work at a company and you're a Microsoft 365 company, OneDrive is part of that Microsoft 365 Office Suite. I'm going to give you six reasons why I like Microsoft OneDrive. Item number one, I use it every day. It is called versioning. Here's an example. I'm going to pull up File Explorer. When you pull up File Explorer, in case you're wondering, there is OneDrive Personal. This is what you get with a Microsoft 365 family plan or individual plan. But then we also have Microsoft OneDrive for work or school. It used to be called Microsoft OneDrive for Business. They changed the name. It'll have the name of your company in it, by the way. When I go to my documents, I'm going to quickly load a file. So up at the top here is an Excel file. I have opened up that file, and I happen to notice that in column F, I have accidentally deleted four cells that have cost in them right in here. And I have no clue what those numbers were. Microsoft OneDrive does versioning in the background. To get to your versioning, you come up to the title bar, click on the title of your file, go to Version History. All the previous versions of this file will load. I'm going to go and open up this one right here at 11:37, open version, restore. By the way, it's giving me a preview of it right here, by the way. If you notice, the cost items are back. I'm going to restore it. And I am back in business with my versioning feature right here. A bonus tip here for you, I wasn't going to cover it, but when we click on the title bar to go to your version history, you can actually rename the file right up here without closing it. That applies to Word, PowerPoint, and Microsoft Excel. So there is the versioning feature. I'm going to go ahead and close this file out. That is the sync icon. Item number two is the ability to share a file with OneDrive. This file is only mine, so every file that you put in OneDrive is yours and only yours. No one else can see it. If you notice, I've already shared a few files. They have a person next to them. I want to share this file with one of my coworkers named Christian. I'm going to right-click on this file. All my OneDrive options are from the word share, which has the OneDrive icon, down to free up space. If you notice, they have lines above them and below free up space. So these are my OneDrive features. I want to hit share. When it comes to sharing, two items you need to know about. Question one, who do you want to share with? And question two, what rights do you want to give them? I know that I want to share this with just one person in my company named Christian, and I want Christian to either have read-only rights, where he can just view the file, or edit rights. You may see an optional one in here about review. Let's not worry about that one. So here comes item one. Who do you want to share with? I click here, and it says sharing settings. Anyone. Don't want to do that right now. People in Chris Menard training. This will be the name of your company. People you choose, that is what I want right here. And then here was that second option. What rights do I want to give Christian? Edit rights, review rights. I do want him to be able to edit this Excel file with me. When I hit apply is when it's going to ask me to type in his email. Apply. There is Christian. I can leave him a message. Please collaborate on this file with me. I'm not going to do it right now just to save time. When I hit send, it'll send an email automatically in Outlook. Christian will get an email, click the link, and I will also be notified that he has opened this file, by the way. I could copy the link that I put up here and maybe throw it into a Teams chat, by the way, also. I am going to click send, though. So he just received an email from me right there. Cool feature, and there is the icon indicating that I've shared this file. You would go to the same place, by the way, share, or you could go to manage access to remove sharing rights from somebody. Item number three, really important, is the Microsoft 365, all these apps are tied in together. So if you're using Microsoft Teams, let me pop into Teams. I'm in Microsoft Teams right now. I had a meeting this morning and that meeting was recorded. So if you're wondering where my meeting recording's at, couple easy ways to find them. One, I'm in chat. This is a great tip. If you want to see just your meetings, you can click on this filter icon. Filter by name is great, but when I click on more options, I just want to see my meetings. So I'm doing all this from chat. And here is the meeting I had this morning. It says your recording is ready. So I click on this meeting and there is my recording. Guess where that recording is stored? You got it. Microsoft OneDrive. In fact, I'm going to go back to File Explorer again. Here is my OneDrive over here. So one item I just told you is just a slight twist on it. All the files you have in OneDrive are yours and only yours. No one else can see them. No one else can view them. With one exception, this folder called Recordings right here, this folder is automatically created when you record a Teams meeting. You get this recording folder, and anyone invited to that meeting can view this meeting. They can't download the recording. It's an MP4 file, but they can view this meeting. So we pop back over into Teams. Now you could, by the way, go and remove everyone's access again because it's a OneDrive file. But anyway, here is this file. This recording is set to expire. You're going to see that a lot. So let me go ahead and give you a bonus tip. Do you want to change the expiration? Sure. Click here. There is the meeting. It's set to expire in 60 days. If I click on expire in 60 days, I have all these cool options. Remove expiration, extend by 60 days, select a date. Just to prove it, I'm going to hit remove expiration. This is a recording I need forever. And now there's no expiration in here. And if I wanted to download this, I'm the one that recorded this meeting, so I have access to download it. And again, it would be an MP4 file. So there is that feature right there. Another cool feature in Teams, by the way, still dealing with this recording. So if you don't like coming in here to chat, I'm going to close this filter, clear it. I'm back on my normal chat. If you come to files, and if you don't see files, just click here and go type in files and then just add it. When you click on files, watch this, go to my files, and you can get to your recordings here also. I usually go to File Explorer and get them, but here are my recordings also right in here. Item number 4 is called Files on Demand. I love this feature. I am back in File Explorer. Here's what Files on Demand means. If I come and see the size of my hard drive, I'm gonna click on this PC. My hard drive is 263 GB, and I've already used 231. I'm sorry, 231 is free. But that is not a really large hard drive, and I've seen hard drives that are only 235 GB, 300. Microsoft OneDrive, by default, would give you 1,000 gigabytes of storage. That is called a terabyte. So Files on Demand is I can store 1,000 gigs of files in Microsoft OneDrive, which is in the cloud, but I don't have to have them all on my computer taking up my hard drive space. So it's called Files on Demand because when I go to Documents, let me just do a sort here. If you notice some of my files, they have a blue cloud. Those files are stored in OneDrive on the cloud. And then when I need one of those files, I'm going to open up this budget 2025 for North America. It's got a blue cloud. When I double click and open up this Excel file, it'll change to that green check mark. Green check mark. Excel file opens. There's nothing in here. This is just for an example. Close out of Excel. So now this file is still a OneDrive file, but I have what's considered a copy or a synced version on my computer. So the big difference between the green check and the blue cloud, you need an internet connection to download that file. But if I was to lose my internet connection right here, I can still open up this budget for 2025 North America. Now, if I don't need this file, or if I just need it maybe 6 months from now, there's no reason to be taking up my valuable hard drive space. So I'm just going to right click on this file. And again, here are OneDrive commands. I'm going to free up space. It's going to change back to the blue cloud because I don't need this local anymore. So that is files on demand for you. One more, I'm going to do this Word document just to prove this works. Right click, free up space, blue cloud, not taking up hard drive space anymore, but I can still get to it because I have an internet connection right now. Searching OneDrive is item number 5, one of my favorite features. To get to OneDrive, so the same way we have Excel desktop, Word desktop, PowerPoint desktop, we have the online versions of PowerPoint, Word, and Excel. OneDrive is the same way. I'm looking at OneDrive in File Explorer, but I want to go to OneDrive on the web, also called OneDrive Online. Couple easy ways to get here. I could just right click, view online. If you don't like that method, your OneDrive icon should be sitting down in your taskbar at the bottom. I don't have my taskbar running, but trust me, there's a blue cloud down there. And if you click on that blue cloud, it'll say view online. I'll just go this method here. View online. I am in OneDrive on the web. Over to the far left is my name. If I go to my files, this is every file I have in OneDrive. What is cool here regarding searching is if I click on the Home tab, the word Home, I only want to see, as an example, Excel files. If I click Excel, I'm only looking at Excel files. If I click the X, I'm back to looking at everything. If I just want to see Word files, click Word, and you can click both. So there is Word and Excel. Another cool feature, it doesn't matter where you're at in OneDrive. If you notice, the search bar is up at the top. Click up in the search bar. It says it's going to search for all files. I start typing in, I'm making this up, I start typing in Atlanta, where I'm located. And it's going to go and find every file with Atlanta when I hit Show More Results. It doesn't matter if Atlanta is in the file name or if the word Atlanta is actually inside of the file. Here's my example. Add quickly. I don't see Atlanta in the file name. Click on it and open it. It is going to open up in Excel online or Excel for the web. You can always come over here and pull this into your desktop app. But by the way, there is Atlanta in cell A6 right there. And item number 6 and the last one. I also, besides OneDrive, love OneNote. I keep all my notes in OneNote. OneDrive and OneNote can follow you around. When I say follow you around, you can put it on your mobile phone. You can access it from any computer, both of those apps. So when you go to save a OneNote notebook, after you've saved it, when you initially save it or create it, it's going to say, do you want to share this with anyone? And the answer is up to you, yes or no. But where do you want to store it? I would encourage you to keep all your OneNote notebooks in OneDrive. So just to demonstrate this, I'm going to go to File. I'm going to make a new one from scratch. New. I'm going to call this, we need a budget notebook for budget for 2024. Create notebook. Look where it's being saved to. This is where I would put it to my company OneDrive. Where do you want to put it? I want to put it in this notebooks folder. That works. Create. Invite people. I'm going to hit not now. You can keep this just yours. But now this notebook that I just created for budget 2025, I can get on my mobile device, I can get from another computer, because I save that OneNote notebook in OneDrive.